pushed the remains of his chicken korma round the plate, searching for small talk, but failing miserably. Margaret smiled at him, with all the genuine warmth of a mortgage advisor turning you down. "You okay?" ventured Keith. "Yes," said Margaret, but her teeth were gritted. It was impossibly awkward. Nobody wanted to mention the elephant in the room. There was an actual elephant in the room. Not only was it taking up all the space, Margaret thought Keith had been having an affair with it. And that was the elephant in the room. Not the elephant in the room, but the fact that Margaret thought that Keith had been having an affair with it. Nellie shifted self-consciously and sighed through her trunk. This had been a mistake. She knows. I don't really know what genre that is. Joining me this evening, on my right, Harry Heath, a procurement manager for a rail company who owns a flock of geese named after world leaders. Claire Barrow, a tax advisor who once had a holiday job sorting Battenberg cake. And their captain, Dan Afshar, a classics graduate who attended both Royal Ascot and the Grand National but didn't see a single horse. Striving not to live up to their team name, they are the Also-Rans. Dan, your team all met in the Mastermind final in 2021. Wasn't he always the year where it was the youngest ever winner?
Yeah, he was exactly half my age, so we don't speak.
And he definitely isn't an also-ran.
How old is he, anyone?
14, I think, 15, something like that.
We don't want to meet that guy. Facing you this evening are, on my left, Jack Lewis, a biology graduate who took the role of David Brent in a play when he was 9. Nina Featherston, a languages graduate who had a childhood fear of diesel from Thomas the Tank Engine. And their captain, Lewis Jones, a barman who is unbeaten after 30 escape rooms. All devoted fans of David Fincher, they are the Video Nasties. I mean, I say fanatics of Fincher, you pitched originally as your team name the Ovophobes. Why
yes.
was that?
Not fans of eggs, any forms of eggs, cooked eggs. I'm okay with them as an ingredient. I know they have a place there. But I don't like a scramble. I don't like a fried. And we were all very much of the same opinion that they're not something we can jive with.
Oh, I nixed that team name because I thought it might be code for misogynists. But it was just the scrambled sort. I do apologise. Good luck. Well done, all of you, for making the quarterfinals. Also, Rans, you won the toss. You'll be going first. Please choose a hieroglyph.
We'll have water, please.
Water. What is the connection between these clues? Here's the first.
Italy. Can we, normally Victor Amanda, but it might be a Victor as well.
Next, please.
TV. I'm not sure that one, no.
Yeah. Okay, next, please. Duke of Denmark. Are they all Emmanuel?
No, I can't see it.
Next, please.
Possibly. We'll try the other manuals, but...
Yeah. We'll say they're all Emmanuel.
I'm afraid they are not all Emmanuel, so a bonus chance for you, Video Nasties.
All murder victims.
Close, but the opposite.
Ah.
The author of Murder in a Minor Key is a certain Jessica Fletcher. The second son of the 15th Duke of Denver is Lord Peter Wimsey. The priest of St Mary Kembleford is Father Brown. And King Victor II is just a really nice clue. Had any of you recently read King and Joker by Peter Dickinson, you would know that he, like the others, is an amateur detective. Okay. So, unfortunately, no points there. What would you like Video Nasties for your own question?
Nina, go ahead.
Lion, please.
Lion. What is the connection between these clues? Here's the first.
E.G. China.
Areas and, like, something. Like zones.
Next, please.
Flags with, like, symbols, symbols of country. Like,
Chinese dragon.
Trying to get
another.
Next, please. Is it their football teams? Because China might be the dragons, Egypt, so they the...
Sphinxes.
OK, yeah.
These sort of national emblems of these countries that fit under these categories.
I need to hear something very specific.
Possibly in a sporting context?
Not in a sporting context. I can't take that answer. I'm going to show the fourth clue to the also-rounds for a possible bonus point.
Coat of arms of these countries feature?
Not a coat of arms. You're right, they are national symbols in a way, but where you would see them is on the tail fin of the national airline.
Ah.
In China, you would see a phoenix on the tail fin. What do you think in Egypt? What mythical thing?
Sphinx.
An eye of Horus.
It's an eye of Horus. Imagine if you're frightened of flying, and as you approach the plane, a sort of giant eye of Horus glaring at
you. The water would be more concerning.
Both at once is what you really don't want. Botanical. Lebanon, you would see a cedar tree. And what about Aer Lingus?
A shamrock.
Shamrock, exactly so. An Australia kangaroo and a crane on Lufthansa planes. And a flag on those other ones at the end there. Let's get some points also around, but which is the question?
Twisted flax, please.
Twisted flax. Picture clues. What do they have in common? Here's the first.
Baby Driver.
Baby Driver.
Oh, it's so like Simon Garfunkel.
Well, yes, or it could be Edgar Wright films.
OK. Can I take another one? Yeah.
I'll say next, please.
Who's that? Oh, wife. Someone's not princess. Sure.
No, next, please.
Boxer, yeah, Simon Garfunkel.
Yeah.
First
Simon Garfunkel songs.
Is the right answer. I've got so much to discuss with you. Let's have a look at all the clues. OK, question one. How on earth did you recognise that as Baby Driver?
Say what you see. I saw a baby in a car.
Well, this is like a child.
Oh, that must be Cecilia.
You said a wife and a princess. Sort of merge the two and down a bit.
Well,
it's the former Irish president, Mary Robinson, with her husband, in whose company she is, of course, Mrs. Robinson. The boxer at clue three. And which clue did you not need?
Bridge over troubled water.
Bridge over troubled water. Off the blocks for 2 points. Well done. Video nasties, what's next?
Jack, go.
Two reads, please.
Two reads. What is the connection between these clues? Here's the first.
Yeah, it is. Jim Geoffrey's and Trump. No. Next, please.
Impenetrable? Is that where the... It's like the impenetrable forest somewhere in...
It's not something I've heard of before.
No, it's a bit wordy as well. Next, please. Oh.
It's not like repeated things. Like, I don't know. It's not like...
I think there is...
Next, please.
Correct. They all give their names to viruses.
That makes sense. Okay. They all give their names to viruses.
They are the origins of the names of viruses. That's right. Can you talk me through the viruses?
Marburg.
Marburg is a university town in Hesse where that particular virus was first recognised.
Is one of them Ebola?
Which one do you think is Ebola?
River in Zaire.
In Zaire, of course, and it's a clue. It's not called Zaire now, but it would have been at the time. What's it called now?
DRC.
DRC, Democratic Republic of the Congo. Not to be confused with...
Republic
of the Congo, otherwise known as...
Congo,
exactly. So I really fear Congo in quiz questions because you can be so right and so wrong at once. A forest in Uganda?
Zika,
exactly so. And, of course, the last one, corona or coronavirus. Well done. Also, Rans, what would you like?
I'll take the eye of Horus, please.
Oh, glowering at you from the back of the plane. Yes. And it's the music question, you see. I told you you weren't to trust it. What do these pieces of music have in common? Here's the first. Dinner's still hot.
You don't want dessert to spoil. It sounds a little bit like one you know.
OK, next, please. She ran away from home in her mother's best car. Next, please. The science rhymes,
the sharpest suits.
ABC. That's the song. The smoky things, except you smoke all the same.
Give me the last one.
Yeah, next, please.
Oh, this is... Marvin Gaye by...
Yeah, so
2 seconds.
So they reference other singers of soul Motown.
Exactly so. They reference great Motown artists. What did we hear?
We heard the third clue was When Smokey Sings.
That's right, ABC, tribute to Smokey Robinson.
And we had Marvin Gaye in clue four.
Marvin Gaye, Charlie Puth featuring Meghan Trainor.
And we didn't recognise the other two.
Levi Stubbs' Tears, the second one.
Levi Stubbs' Tears, Billy Bragg was the second one. And Harry, I think you knew it was Ollie Murs with a 2015 track, Stevie Knows, which is about Stevie Wonder. One question remains for you, Video Nasties, the Horned Viper. How nasty is it? Let's find out.
Phone tracker. Is it a film or something that somebody's playing?
I don't think so. Next, please.
No, it could be a word.
Their words, yeah. For sure. What are the words for excess? access flash.
Fab.
It's fab with an extra L.
I think we need
next
more.
Piece.
Few. I still don't have anything.
Okay. Next piece.
Two seconds.
So are they sort of...
Is it F and PH?
Yeah, things that are, if one's spelt with an F, one's spelt with a PH is the same word. So they sound the same.
Well done, Jack. I think seem to spot that just the last minute. I was interested that at clue two, you were saying flab and fab, which I hadn't noticed. It's an alternative word riddle, but that's not the word riddle we're doing. Jack, can you talk me through the words?
Only the last one, which is Philly and Philly for Philadelphia.
OK, but knowing it's F and PH, what might the other ones be?
Few and few,
a clue three.
The first one, is it freak and freak?
Freak and freak. And then the one that isn't flab and fab is...
Oh, fat and fat.
Yeah.
Fat and fat. Exactly so. That means at the end of round one, the Video Nasties have 2 points, the Also-Rans have three. On to round two, and also rounds, you can kick off again. What would you like?
Two reads, please.
Two reads. What will come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
Multiple.
Next, please.
Airy.
A-I-O-U, A-E-O-U.
Ooh. So we're missing...
So, missing out E, missing an I, missing a U. So something with A-E-I-O. Okay, so same lion. This is a U, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's a bit weak, but we'll say same lion.
All right, you can have that. I'm impressed you're doing it after two clues. What's happening here?
So it's to do with the vowels. So the vowels are in order, but the first clue is missing an E, the second an I, third, an O, and the fourth.
You didn't need to see cesium, which is missing the O, and something with A, E, I, and O, abstention, affection, same lion. I mean, some people would make that two words rather than one, but I'm assuming you're thinking of your old friend Simon, same lion from school, who wrote it all out in one.
That's it, yeah.
Well-quizzed. Video Nasties, what would you like?
Yeah, go ahead.
I have Horus, please.
I have Horus. What would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
Actor. Director. Yeah. Can't think of what it might be. Next, please. They are directors. Could be people in charge of the National Theatre.
Yeah, but I don't
know. I think we're going backwards.
The ballpark.
I think it started with maybe Olivier. Yeah, next, please.
Oh, yeah, might be Olivier.
I haven't got anything else. It's definitely directors. I can't think what else it might be.
Yeah,
that's right. OK. We're going to go first, Laurence Olivier.
Very well done. Nice. Good knowledge. What is this sequence?
Is it the heads of the National Theatre?
It's the artistic directors of the Royal National Theatre going back towards the first one. Sir Laurence Olivier. Dear Larry. Well done. Also, Rans, what would you like?
Go on, Claire.
Horned Viper, please.
Horned Viper. What will come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
Pan's Labyrinth. Labyrinth the Singer.
Yeah, next, please.
Spring Yard or Spring Yard.
Can that be an anagram of some sort? Next, please.
Marble Arch.
Anything to the game?
Labyrinth's marble. What does Labyrinth have? It's a maze.
Statues.
2 seconds.
Statue.
Not a sequence, I'm afraid. Video Nasties, do you know?
Is it Green Hill?
The answer is Green Hill. And why is that?
They're the Sonic the Hedgehog zones in the first game.
The zones in Sonic the Hedgehog. I'm again going backwards towards the first level, Green Hill. I was spending most of that trying to make an anagram out of Spring Yard. I haven't got brother. Yap Drings, I've got.
Same line.
And Randy Priggs. Could have been Randy Briggs.
Oh, OK.
I don't know if that's broadcastable. Very well, then, you get a bonus point, Video Nasties, and a question. Which one?
Josh, you want
to go? Water, please.
Water. What would come forth in this picture sequence?
OK.
Here's the first.
Chessboard. That is the...
King on E8.
King on E8. Is it Okay. Next, please.
King on g6. E8, g6.
I know nothing about chess.
No.
Let's get another. Next, please.
Is this? This isn't.
Is that a different piece?
It's not Fool's Mate or something like that.
I think what, if you have any idea what that is, I think you should.
That's the Queen E2.
You should describe it on the last one.
I can say a random bit. Let's say the Queen on c4.
Not it, I'm afraid. Also, Rans, do you know?
King on c3.
Yes, it is. Now, I love this question. This is a question for the great Mike Turner, one of our very long-standing question writers. It's all chess is a weakness, I think. You say you don't know much about chess. Generally, people come here, they don't know chess notation, but this isn't a chess question.
No.
What is this question?
Yeah, unfortunately, we saw this straight away. It was a series of monarchs, so it's E8, Edward VIII, mm-hmm. G6 for George VI. Mm-hmm. Queen is obviously Elizabeth II, and then King Charles III. C3.
King on C3. Well done for that bonus. Which question will you have for yourselves?
We'll have the same line, please.
Same line coming your way. Let's hope old Simon brings you luck. What comes forth in this sequence is the first.
Semaphore. Do we know Robert Freeman is?
Has been invented.
Yeah, next, please. Chris, stretched image.
Oh, is this these Beatles album covers with a help and then maybe like, is that like...
So it would be Peter Blake with the... who did
Potentially did some of the peppers.
It's the most famous one, isn't it?
Yeah, I think it's worth a shot.
Yeah. So Peter Blake and then a lot of people.
Very well done, you spotted that early. Let's have a look at all the clues. What is being described?
Well, Harry spotted it, so Harry...
These are Beatles album covers going... backwards or forwards?
Oh, are they going forwards? It's the fifth to the eighth album. What are those albums? Can you describe the covers, please, clue by clue?
Well, we've got Help, where they're doing Semaphore, but not of Help.
The Beatles in a row, exactly, and Robert Freeman took the photo.
And then the stretchy... Is that... I'm struggling to remember. Is that Rubber Soul?
It's Rubber Soul. Yeah, they look a bit sort of stretchy. And yeah. Robert Freeman didn't mean that to be the image, but they saw it and said, oh, we quite like that one. The black and white collage drawing.
Revolver?
That's Revolver, exactly. So we're going towards, of course...
The Sgt. Pepper's.
Sgt. Pepper album. Exactly so. Good spot. Video Nasties, one question remains, the twisted facts. What would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
Anything. South American-y.
Yeah. Car or something.
Next, please. I think this is... mountains. It's going to be mountains. Could it be biggest mountains in South America?
Which one is it? I mean,
Aconcagua.
But I'd take another one.
Yeah. Next, please.
Yeah, that was the second one, yes.
Yeah, sorry. Aconcagua. Aconcagua.
Is the right answer. And can you tell me why? And in telling me why, I'd like you to say out loud the name of every clue you're looking at.
Huascaran,
mm-hmm.
I would guess, is the fourth highest mountain in South America.
Yes, it is.
Monte Pisces.
I mean, it can't be.
It can't be. But that's how I'm saying it.
I mean, should we go with Monte Pisces?
If you wish.
OK.
Yes,
I mean, I've shouted Randy Priggs at some point in the programme, so we may be off air
Hoyos
already.
Hoyos del Soldado.
I beg your pardon?
Hoyos del Soldado.
Ojos?
I don't know.
Who speaks Spanish?
Ojos.
Very nice. Ojos del Salado. And what does it mean?
Eyes of sun.
Eyes of the salty one. Mm. The kind of thing you'd see on an Egyptian tail fin. And Aconcagua. So we're going towards the highest mountain in South America. That means at the end of round two, the Video Nasties have 7 points, the Also-Rans have 10. Time for round three, the connecting wall. Video Nasties, you will choose which of these nasty walls you want, and which is it?
Water, please.
Water, exactly, as everyone's been choosing all series. 2.5 minutes to solve the water wall, starting now.
Okay.
Blomqvist, is that James Bond right as well?
Oh, no, yeah, Blomqvist, Bond, Blomq, or Azrael, or all characters played by Daniel Craig. So yeah, there'll be one more.
Warren, Holt, Lodge, and Den, Burrow.
Yeah.
Lair as well, the six.
Six, OK, we'll leave that.
Cannon Street. Cannon Street, Bond Street, Baker Street, Warren Street. Or Old Street.
OK, is that five?
Yeah, it's five. Electric Eel.
You got rid of one of the...
got rid of
Daniel Craig
now, so it's left. Got two gaps.
Den.
Blanc.
Blanc. And all right, I'll just do this one more.
Okay.
So a hatch, an eel is not a place where a thing lives.
Can you add letters or take away?
I think hatch is most likely to be.
Yeah, that's not a place.
Okay, Thatcher. Peel.
Peel, okay. Yes.
Blair.
Eden.
Yeah.
There you go. You solved the wall. Very well done. What about the connections? Tell me about the first group, Baker, Bond, and so on.
London streets.
I mean, yeah, so there actually are London streets. We think actually tube stations if you add a street, but they're streets as well, so both are correct. And the next group, Blanc, Asriel, and so on.
Characters played on film by Daniel Craig.
Yes, very well done. What are those films? What can you tell me about the characters?
Benoit Blanc from Knives Out and Glass Onion. Lord Asriel from the rather bad Northern Lights adaptation, The Golden Compass. Michael Blomqvist, I think, from The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, directed by David Fincher.
Yes. He's a director, is he?
He's a director.
Okay.
Yeah. Hughes, Nothing's Coming to
Terms.
Ted Hughes in Sylvia, when Gwyneth Paltrow played Sylvia Plath. When you say it's a bad adaptation, you mean you like the stories but not the film?
Yeah, the books are great. The recent TV series was very good, but that film, no. Good cast, not well made.
Fair enough. And the next group, Den, Lair, and so on.
British Prime Minister's missing a first letter.
Very well spotted. That is a tough word one. Mm. Eden, Blair, Thatcher, Peel. And the last group, Burrow, Lodge, and so on.
Places where animals live.
Animal shelters, exactly so. So, 4 points and 4 points and 2 points make 10. Very well done. Let's bring in their opponents now, give them the other wall, see what happens. The Lion Wall for you also, Rans. 2.5 minutes if you need them, starting now.
Okay, so we've got Alexander's, maybe. I'm trying to think what else Litvinenko could be.
It's poisoned.
Well, there's Looney Tunes character, Speedy Gonzales, Bug, Dirt, Bunny, Doc. Pig. And there's Pig.
And Duck? Daffy Duck?
Duck,
Bugs Bunny.
Should we try missing out Gonzales?
Crouch,
missing out
Squat, Stoop,
Bunny,
Hunch, of all positions.
Coyote, miss out Pig.
Crouch, squat, stoop, and hunch.
And it must be another one. Duck.
Oh, yeah.
Stoop, crouch, duck, squat, hunch. So miss out squat, miss out hunch, miss out crouch.
Okay.
So we've got Alexander Litvinenko. These all Ukrainians or Russians?
Well, he was Russian. I don't know where else goes with him, though.
So, carry on, doctor.
Is Baron at the start of Baronet? Does anything else go? Or. Radon. Radon could be a.
Rad as a unit.
Rad, let's try it.
Hi, you got.
So, is there another.
Should we try with some of the Looney Tunes? Yeah, maybe Casanova.
Yeah. Okay, let's try
the crowd. Bar as a unit, Rad as a unit.
Ooh, I like that. Koi, that's not a coyote, maybe.
No. So we've got anything else?
Litvinenko. Oh, he was played by David Tennant, as was the Doctor, and he also played Casanova.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I don't know who else he played.
Hardy.
Okay, should we try?
Barnett. Or Gonzales.
Crouch. Barty Crouch.
Yes.
I'll try those four.
Doctor, Litvinenko, Crouch, and Asriel.
No, I'm not like to see. What have we got that can't be any either of those other groups?
30 seconds.
Road.
Pig. What's Pig?
So, Percy Pig. Speedy Gonzales. So, who else could Dave Tennant have played? So, we've got those.
Can you play Hardy? No, I think we might have tried that one.
No, let's try. Let's have the Doctor. There we go.
So, 10 seconds. Quickly try the
Cody, Pig, Bunny.
Gonzales.
Oh, I can't tell you how tense that was to watch. But you've solved the wall with just a few seconds to spare. Let's go through the groups. First group, hunch, stoop, and so on.
It's to bend down.
Yes, yeah, to sort of lower the body. And the next group, crouch, hardy, and so on.
These are all played by David Tennant.
That's exactly right. And I think you knew that's Barty Crouch in Harry Potter. Hardy, do you know?
I don't know Hardy.
It's Alec Hardy in Broadchurch, that great show, Broadchurch. He was the detective. Litvinenko, of course, he played, and Casanova. And the next group, Pig, Bunny, Coyote, Gonzales.
Cartoon characters.
Looney Tunes.
They're Looney Tunes characters, and I just feel like you had them, and it's like they were hopping out of your hand and running down the road laughing. Who are those characters?
We've got Porky Pig, mm-hmm. Bugs Bunny, mm-hmm. Wile E. Coyote, and Speedy Gonzales.
Exactly so. And the last group, Dr. Baronet, and so on.
Did we have anything other than units? But I can't see any other units.
Yeah, say they're units of measurement.
Not it. It is a word one. They can all be abbreviated to their first and last letter. Dr. BT, Radon, obviously the symbol is RN, and Road for RD. But you solved the wall and gave me three connections, total of 7 points. Well done. Let's have a look at the scores going into the final round. The Video Nasties have 17 points. The Also-Rans have 17 points. So it is a close race to the finish, a hotly contested tug of war for that place in the semi-final between two very deserving teams. I'm sorry any of you has to go, but three of you do. So fingers on buzzers, please, teams. I can tell you that the first group of disguised clues are all items of tableware. Also rans?
Oyster knife.
Correct. Also rans?
Corn on the cob holder.
Well done. Video Nasties?
Winkle picker.
Yes, it is. Nasties?
Tasting fork.
I'll take that answer. I was expecting toasting fork, but I think a tasting fork is also a thing. The next group are all not tableware. Also rans?
Tuning fork.
Well done. Nasties?
Flying saucer.
Correct. Also rans?
Crown green bowls.
Yes, it is. Also rans?
Tectonic plates.
Very well done. Next category, their surnames rhyme just about with supermarket names. Also rans?
Peter Capaldi.
And Aldi. Nasties?
Vanessa Hudgens.
And Budgens. Video Nasties.
Tom Marvolo Riddle.
And Little. No time to shout Johnny Marr and Spa, because the bell has gone to the end of the quiz, and looking at the final scores, I mean, it's another very close game. Just a 1 point gap. One team has 22 points, one team has 23 points, and the team with 23 points going into the semi-final is the Also-Rans. Very well played. Video Nasties. I mean, it's better than a 20-point trouncing, but so frustrating, 1 point in it. I mean, what a great performance from all of you over the contest. Thank you so much for playing. And thank you for watching Only Connect, the show that takes no prisoners. Honestly, it doesn't. They're all here voluntarily. Goodbye.